Hey guys, I'm Pixel Dan, and this is a review of the San Diego Comic-Con 2016 exclusive Thundercats, Wile E. Kit and Wile E. Cat from Mattel. That's right, Mattel's brand new line of 6-inch scale articulated Thundercats action figures kicks off with this 2-pack featuring Kit and Cat that was sold exclusively at San Diego Comic-Con. Let's go ahead and check it out. As you can see, it comes in a beautiful box. It fully showcases both Kit and Kat on the inside. We've got this great kind of clear plastic shell over the whole box, so that way you can see everything on the inside. And you can kind of see in the background there, there's a nice little piece of artwork of the Cat's Lair that just makes a really great scenic view. When you rotate the box around to the backside, we have some equally gorgeous artwork of both Wile E. Kit and Wile E. Cat on their hoverboards. And way in the background, you can see the rest of the Thundercats team. I absolutely love the artwork here. It really makes this whole package feel special. But that is not the only thing that makes this package feel special. Once you remove the little clear plastic slip cover, you can cut the tape up on the corners up here on the top of the box, and the entire thing folds open for a really cool display scene. So you can see the front little flaps kind of fold open, and you can see we just have Lion-O with the sword held up in front of his face. One of the flaps has the Thundercats logo, while the other one has the Eye of Thundera, so it's pretty cool. You can actually flip those however you want to, but you fold those open on the sides, and then after you cut the little slits on the top of the box, you can fold these out on the top of the box as well. So the entire package opens up to this gorgeous scene with the Cat's Lair in the background and some nice little kind of foresty areas down here on the sides. This is going to make a really cool little diorama piece that you can stand Kit and Cat in front of, or the rest of the Thundercats team when we get it. So, really great packaging. It's very, very nicely done, but let's go and take a closer look at these figures outside of this box. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at Kit and Kat outside of the packaging. So both of the figures here stand right at about 5 inches tall, as you can see. Actually, their hair stands just a little bit above that. When Lion-O and the rest of the bunch come out, they're actually likely going to be closer to 7 inches. I would imagine they're about roughly the same scale as what we've seen with He-Man and company from the Masters of the Universe Classics line, since they kind of fit right in with the styling that Mattel did with those. So these are smaller characters, and as you can see, of course, they are on those skinnier bucks as well, since they are children. So these are completely new sculpts for the Thundercats line, and I gotta say, they look really great. At first glance, these figures do a great job of capturing exactly as I remember these characters looking in the cartoon series. Let's go and take a look at them one by one. We will start by taking a look at Wile E. Cat here. I will say that the paint deco is pretty nice on these. There's a great range of colors that you can see, and the sculpts are fantastic. The Four Horsemen really nailed the sculpts with these, so great work to those guys. You can see the way that the hair has got a great sculpt to it. It's also got a nice coloring to it. I love the way that it's got a bit of a dry brushing in there, so it kind of dirties up the hair just a little bit to give it a little bit of a, you know, a little bit more flavor to it, a little bit more design. I like that quite a bit. And then you can see the face has got that lighter paint on there. Now, I have noticed on both of these figures there are going to be a few paint blemishes. I'll point those out as I find them. One of them is right here above the eye, the left eye there on Cat. You can see he didn't quite get painted all of the way. But aside from that, it's pretty crisp and clean. I love the eyes, those bright red cat eyes in there with the nice black outlines. All of that looks really nice. You can see the colors continue onto the back of the figure. You got the black lines kind of coming through the top of the orange part of the hair. Just a really nice sculpt and design there. So you come down the rest of the figure, he is wearing sort of an orange and brown, a lot of tan colors going on here basically, and it's pretty clean for the most part. We do have a little bit more paint rub over here on the arm. We got the Thundercats logo on his belt. It's a little misprinted on mine. I think that's a little bit lower than it should be. The black cat should be more in the center of that, so you can see I got a little bit more space at the top of mine than I should. And all the way down to the boots there. So overall, I think the sculpt is really nice. The paint could use a little bit of improvement, but you know what? I've seen a lot worse, so not too terrible on this guy. One of the things I really like on both of these characters, you'll see that he's got his little whip weapon rolled up, coiled up, and plugged into the back. So this is sculpted just like this. It's very nicely sculpted. Great paint deco on there, so it really stands out. Just got a little peg that plugs right there on the back of his belt. Very, very nice. So let's go ahead and bring in his sister, Wily Kit, and take a closer look at her. We'll go ahead and start again on that head sculpt. Right away, this really stood out to me. You can see she's got a lot of white paint splotches on her face. So again, a bit of a bummer. I just wish it was a little bit more of a clean paint job. But the hair is still very nicely sculpted. Love that black line kind of coming through, tipping off onto the back there. Just really, really nice. And then coming down onto her arms and her shoulders, we've got some blue paint blobs. So I've seen a lot of that on these two. Yeah, just little paint specks on there. But otherwise, I do love the bright colors that are used here. Nice bright blue and bright pinkish purple color. The cat emblem looks a little bit better on her shirt than Cat's belt does. And then, of course, she's got the open feet down here. You know, she's kind of got the wraps that just go around her feet, the open toes there. And just like with Wily Cat, she's got a pink little lasso that is coiled up there and has a little plug that just plugs right into the back of her belt. So overall, the sculpts, very nice on these guys. The paint jobs are pretty decent with just a few blemishes, but you can see they're bright and colorful, and they do a really great job of matching the characters from that original cartoon series. So both of these figures come with a bunch of different accessories. First things first, they each come with a pair of interchangeable hands. So you'll notice with Kit here, we've got her with an open-palmed hand. She has two hands that are just kind of slightly, where the fingers are slightly curled. You can see a left hand and a right hand, both the same way. And then she's got another left hand that's more in a gripping pose, which is going to be for her lasso accessory. So if you want to swap that out, it's very easy. Just give a nice tug here. It pops out. It's just a little peg system. Pops right out of socket. We can take the new hand here. We can push it in place. It holds very well. Still articulates. Still functions. And that's how you can swap out the hands there. So that way you can work it with some of the different accessories. Wily Cat is the same way. You'll notice he's got kind of two open hands on right now. The fingers are a little warped on there. You can see how curled they are. That's just from the packaging. You can easily bend those back into place. But if you want to swap out his hands, he does have also a more curled left hand. And then he's also got a gripping right hand. So if we want to swap that out, we can easily just pull that right out of socket. We can plug the new hand in its place, and that's going to be for holding on to his whip accessory, which I'm going to show you in just a bit. But Wily Cat also comes with one other hand accessory. This one is holding on to his little smoke pellets. Check that out. Pretty cool. So we can pop out the left hand if we want to. And in its place, we can pop in this really cool little smoke pellet hand. Now, I will say it's a little top heavy. You can see that the arm's a bit loose. It does have a tendency to fall down when he's holding this, so you're going to have to kind of bend the articulation a bit, and you can find a place to get him to hold it. It's really cool looking. There's a nice plume of smoke that's very nicely painted. It's got a great variance in whites and grays in here, and then you can see the little yellow, red, and blue pellets that he's holding in his hand. That is just a really fun extra accessory there. So I talked about the whip and the lasso. So those are the other accessories that both Kit and Cat come with here. This is Wily Cat's little like double tail whip thing he's got going on. You can see it's made of a very pliable plastic, but it's still painted very nicely. You can see we got the darker brown on the handle. It's kind of a light tan. And then at the tip, we got the little yellow like ball type things there. So you can easily get him to hold that with his gripping hand. Plugs in very nicely there. And then for Wily Kit, she's got that pink lasso accessory. So again, very gummy material, nice and pliable, which is really nice. And then we can get her to hold that with her gripping hand, and it arms our cats up. So very, very cool, really nice accessories. But that is not all we get, because of course Wily Kit and Wily Cat are known for traveling around on their cool little hoverboard type things. Yeah, that's what they are, right? They're like hoverboards. So each of them comes with their own hoverboard. They are painted to match the characters, so they're very nice. I do have some scuffs on mine. It looks like, I don't know if that's turning out on camera, because I've already had my cat standing on there, and it looks like the brown of his boots kind of scuffed up the board a little bit. So might be something you want to watch out for. I think it's the type of plastic that this is made of. The paint kind of feels like it could scrape right off, so I would be really careful with that. In fact, I've got some chips on here. already. So they're really cool looking. I think it's just the material that they're made of is going to make the paint a little little cautious. So just be careful with that. Now, each of them do come with these cool little clear flight stands. And you can see they are articulated. It's very, very tight articulation, which is good because that way the boards won't fall over when the cats are standing on them. But in order to get these plugged into the boards, if you look at the bottom here, you'll just insert the little tab in the front. We got a little peg there. Slide it forward and it locks it in place. And now we've got our little hoverboards. Look at that. Two of them, both with clear stands. And they're ready for Kit and Kat to stand on. And they look really cool. You're going to position on those boards there. And it's really fun just kind of posing those guys around, recreating some scenes straight like you remember it right out of the animated series. So really great accessories here. And then, of course, if you want to make things even more fun, we bring in that backdrop that is the box from the beginning of the video. You stand that behind the figures, and it looks really cool. And like I said, this is going to be a neat little display piece to put on your shelf if you want to. And you can put all of your Mattel Thundercats team right there in front of it. Might make a great little backdrop. Alright guys, it's comparison time! Now in the vintage LJ and Thundercats line, there are actually two versions of Wile E. Kit and Wile E. Kat. First of all, there were a set of non-articulated figures. So that's what I've got standing here. You can see the comparison between those old non-articulated LJN figures and the new figures here from Mattel. But they did also release articulated versions, and while I don't have the vintage Wile E. Kat, I do have the articulated vintage Wile E. Kit, so I'll go and throw her in there as well so you can see what these guys look like. And of course, it wouldn't be complete without comparing them to the 2011 releases from Bandai. Now, they had a completely different design for that cartoon series, which I actually liked quite a bit, but this still gives you a cool idea of what the toys look like standing side by side. So there you go, my friends. There is a look at the new San Diego Comic-Con 2016 exclusive Thundercats Wile E. Kit and Wile E. Kat from Mattel. This kicks off the new Thundercats line from Mattel. We do have a few more figures coming this year, with Lion-O being the next figure. So the only way to get Wile E. Kit and Wile E. Kat was at San Diego Comic-Con, and the very limited amount of stock that hit online sold out instantly, unfortunately. They are really cool figures, with my only complaints being minor with the paint deco. I wish it was just a little bit cleaner. But otherwise, I think they're really fun figures. They're definitely great sculpts. They come with a lot of cool accessories. It is just a bit of a bummer that these main team members were only available at San Diego Comic-Con. So you guys are going to have to do some hunting on the secondary market if you want to pick them up and add them to your collection. Happy hunting, my friends! And hey guys, if you enjoyed this video, then why not hit the like button and also be sure to subscribe, because I'll definitely have some more Thundercats reviews on the way, and you're not going to want to miss out on those. Until next time, my friends!